Hi there, my name is Ferdy Korpershoek and I want to welcome you in this course, How to Become an Online Entrepreneur. And in this episode, episode 6, we will talk about ConvertKit, how to make an email list, grow your email list, and how to send emails on autopilot in order to get people to buy your products or make use of your service. Let me give you a brief overview of ConvertKit. Here at the homepage, we have an overview of our latest subscribers. I have no forms active yet, so this was only a test opt-in. Here I have three forms. So this is an overview of all the information on your mailing list. And if we go to forms, we can create a landing page and a form. And the forms and the landing pages are the ways to get opt-ins into your email list. We also have sequences. When people opt in, you can send them a sequence. And if we create a new sequence, it is a sequence of emails that you can send after each other. You can say one day after people opted in, you can send them an email with some introduction, some text, maybe a link to a video. The day after that, maybe you can say 2 days after that, I want to send it to them, and not on Tuesdays because then it's my broadcast email. So that's all automated. And the great thing is you can change them all in one page. You don't have to go to different pages. You have immediate access to all those emails. You can delete them. You can change the order. You can add emails. Then we have the broadcast. Here we can send email to our whole list, but you can also select certain segments or tags. I'll talk about that. Then we have our subscribers. Here you see the information about every subscriber and in which segments they are and which tags they have. And if you want to broadcast an email to your whole subscriber database, then you can say, I want to only send them to certain segments, and in those segments, not to the people with certain tags. So you can filter your broadcast using segments and tags. And here comes the great power of ConvertKit. If I click on automations, you can add rules. A rule, if somebody opts in through my ebook opt-in, then they will be added to this sequence. And if I want to sell them a course in that sequence and they buy that course, then I can add a rule. If they buy that course, they go from this sequence to a different sequence. Because if I'm trying to sell a course and I send 5 emails and in the first email somebody buys a course, then the second, a third, and fourth email are not relevant anymore because they already bought the product. And ConvertKit will help you to automate this. So if you set everything up correctly, then you can sit back and enjoy everything that will happen to your email list. People will opt in automatically and they will be sent automatic emails. And when they buy something from you, they will automatically be sent to a different email list or to a different sequence. And that's the power of ConvertKit. So let's get started. In order to get ConvertKit, go to wp-king.com. Go to resources. And here you see it somewhere over here, ConvertKit. Try ConvertKit. Email marketing for professional bloggers. We can click on get started, but we can also click on request a demo. I will do that. I'll leave my first name, last name, email. How many email subscribers do you have in your current list? If you don't have a current list, just say 0. I have only 150, something like that. My website. My current provider is MailChimp. And I request the demo. See ConvertKit in action. Watch this video. So if you've watched the video and you're excited, then click on get started. I want to say upfront that I'm an affiliate of ConvertKit. So if you buy this tool through my affiliate link, then I will get a commission. You don't pay more, but I will get a commission. And in that way, you help me to build my channel. So thank you for that. If you have a list already, you can see how many subscribers you have. 0 to 1,000, 1,000 to 3,000, 3,000 to 5,000, or a bigger list. And then you get a custom price. I'm over here. $29 per month. If we take a look at ferdykorpershoek.com, I scroll down, the price of my course is $69. So if I can sell only one course per month and I pay $29 per month, I still have profit. And this tool will help you to get more sales. And it states ConvertKit will be the best money you'll ever spend to grow your audience. And I will show you how it goes, how many sales I get from the subscribers. So I go for this one and I click get started. My email address, and I have to choose a password, and the billing info. It needs to be credit card, and now I create my account. So just one more step before you continue. Please confirm your email address by clicking on the link in the email we sent to you. Here it is. Verify your email. That's great. I think I can close this one now. And this one, and this one. And I go further and fill in my details. Save your information. And you can watch a movie if you want to, how to create a form, and watch all those movies. And you see how far you are. The first thing I want to do is go to account. I click on it and I say my company name is Ferdy Korpershoek Productions. I save the settings. Then I take a look at my profile. That's all fine. Then I go to email, and you could say, I don't want to send emails on Sunday. That's up to you. Save the settings. And then the billing. Here it shows my plan is until 1000 subscribers. If I get more than 1000, the plan automatically upgrades. And don't think, oh no, then I have to pay more. But think like, okay, then I can sell my products and services to more people. So it's only a better thing when you have to pay more because you're getting more subscribers. Go back to the homepage. We are going to create a form by clicking on this button, and we can choose a landing page or a form. I will create a form, and there are three kinds of forms. This one, it's a simple form with a little bit text around it. This one has more information, and this is a really simple one. You can always change it later. So if I would choose the third option, I can change this text. Or change this text, but I like it. You can change this to join now, and you can save it. You can change the colors, and when it comes to colors, I always like to use the green button, the button color, which is 008000. Press OK. Text color, here it's 666, I would like 333. And the accent color, maybe the green one, but then a little bit lighter, like that. Now we can save it again. And we go to settings, and here it says the form name. You're the only one who sees this, it's just for your organization. So I will say Ferdy Korpershoek newsletter. And this is the form or a landing page, it's a form. And what should happen when a visitor subscribes? You can show a message, or you can send them to a different page and put a video over there with thank you for subscribing. This is what you need to do. So it's up to you. For now, I leave it as show success message. Success, now check your email to confirm your subscription. When people subscribe for an ebook or something like that, or for discounts, you can send them to a sequence of emails they will get. You can type them up front and then put them on automatic pilot. And if somebody subscribes, they get an email the first day and the third day. But I will talk to you about it later. For now, I leave it as this. Save it and go to incentive email. We want to send a double opt-in, so people have to confirm. If you uncheck this, they will go automatically to the list as soon as they subscribe, but then people can subscribe other email addresses. So I think it's better to turn this on. And subject, important, confirm your subscription. I don't know why. I like this. You can change this text. You can say, download your ebook PDF. And it's good to have you. Something like that. And after that, you can send them to a welcomes page. For instance, ferdykorpershoek.com/welcome. And there you can put a video or put the link of the ebook again. You can also put an ebook within ConvertKit. So you can upload it over here. And then it will be sent within the email. But I would like to send them to a page, to the welcome page. And you can also say auto confirm new member. So even if they don't confirm, so it says confirm below, and by clicking this button, they confirm. But you can also say, you know what, also without confirmation, they will become new members. I uncheck it. And you can also send subscribers data after they have confirmed. I uncheck this also. I save it. So if I click on this button, they go to the thank you page, which is this one. I save it. We can change the style. we started with the naked one, we can change it to the full one or to the minimal one. And it can be inline in the text or model. If you click model, you get different options. That means that when people scroll through your page on a certain percentage, here you see how far they are. And if they come over here, then it pops up. And then they say, then you can show this information over here or slide in. So when you scroll, all of a sudden it comes from right to the left over here. There are a few ways. I use a plugin for that, but you can use it for now if you want to. I like to have it inline, so I'll just put it over here. And if somebody has already subscribed, then they don't need it anymore. Then you can select a few options to continue to show the form or hide the form or show some custom content. And then you can type some HTML text over here. I would say hide the form. I save it. So now we have saved it and we go back to the style. We have now the full style instead of the naked style. We could go back to content over here and we can change this. So now we could change those colors again. And I could change this color to blue one, like that. I can play around with this if I want to. I can change this text, first name, email address. These are the only two things I use, first name and email address. I don't want more. The longer the list you will get that they need to fill in, the less people will subscribe or join. We won't send you spam. You can change this text. Your information is 100% safe with us. Subscribe to get our latest content, or I can say download our ebook. Download our ebook and learn how to start your online business from scratch. In the last video, I showed you how to create an ebook and how to create a cover. I will get a cover image. It's over here, the PNG. Now it's uploading over here. Download our ebook and learn how to start your online business from scratch. One more time. And it's the same style, like this. So it's one style, I save it. And if I click on view, I can see how it looks. Download our ebook and learn how to start your online business from scratch. Now I want to implement this into my website. How can we do that? I go to settings and here to embed. We can do it three ways. The first one is through a JavaScript. Copy this and go to your website. I go to edit the front page. And I will bring it here between the header and the text, content element, code block. I drag it over here. I click on it and I paste the code. I save it, update it, and I refresh our page. And here it is. Download our ebook, first name, email address. And it says powered by ConvertKit. So let's try it. ferdy.corpushoek@gmail.com and join now. I'm not a robot. Submit. Check your email. If I go to my Gmail, info@ferdy.corpushoek.com, important, confirm your subscription. I click on it. Thanks for signing up. Click the link below to confirm your subscription and you'll be on your way. It's good to have you. My address, I can click on unsubscribe and I can click download the ebook. That's my confirmation. Now I'll be sent to ferdy.corpushoek.com/welcome and it's not found. So we'll create it in a minute. What I want to change first, if I go over here, I see it's from info@ferdy.corpushoek.com. I want to change it to a name. So I go to ConvertKit, open my account in a new tab by holding command. I go to email. And from name is ferdy.corpushoek. Save settings. And now let's try the HTML script. So I go for raw HTML. I copy it clicking on Command C. I edit the page and I click on this code block. Select everything, Command A, Command V. Save it, update it, and refresh. And it probably looks exactly the same. And now the third one, it's something else. We need to have the ConvertKit WordPress plugin. So let's go to the backend, go to plugins, new, and search for ConvertKit. Over here, I install it now and I activate it. I click on the settings, my API key, let's go to save it. I go to account, my API key, and in order to get the secret, click here on show. I copy this, I paste it, and I say save change. Now if I go to the website, for instance to a blog page or a blog post, I scroll down, I see nothing, and if I edit this post and I scroll down, here it says ConvertKit form, show Freddy Korpczuk newsletter. So people will opt in on this newsletter, and that's it. I say update, click on view post in a new tab, and below this post, download our ebook. And when I go to a different blog post, you won't see it unless I again activate it. So I scroll down again, update, and view the post. And there it is. I like to use JavaScript. And there are form integrations, Twitter, Inbounce, and you can configure that. And there are other options. You can delete a form or archive it, or you can duplicate it. And what I like to show you, if I go to style and I want to change it to naked, and I save it, and I go to the homepage, you can change the style. And again, of course, you can go to content and change it over here. So if I would say the color needs to be green, I say okay, I save it. It says it's saved. I refresh it. Now it's green. So that's how it works. And if I go back to the settings one more time, if I go to the style again, what should we do to return visitors who already subscribed? If you say hide this form, save it, and we refresh this, and we have already subscribed, then the form disappears. Also here at the blog post, I scroll down and it's gone. And if I go to style and I say continue to show the form and I refresh, it's still there. So that's how it works with our first form. I like to hide the form after people subscribed, save the form. And now let's take a look at creating a sequence. Sequence is another word for autoresponder. It means when somebody subscribes, he gets a sequence of emails in the couple of days after he subscribes. It can be 3 days with 3 emails. It can be a year with 20 emails. We can decide it by ourselves. So we just made a form and now we're going to sequences. After that, we go to broadcast, subscribers, automations. And now we go to the second one, sequences. I click on it. And we have to create our first sequence. So I click over here and sequence name is Freddy Korpczuk ebook. My plan is I will give a free ebook with information about how to create your online business. And I give valuable information in that ebook, but I want to drive them to buying my course because there I also show you how you need to do it instead of only saying what needs to be done. So I say create a sequence. And what you see here are 8 emails that will be sent to everybody that signs up for the Freddy Korpczuk ebook sequence. And the sequence can be added to every sign up form. We can add it later when we save this. What you see, the first email, and here's some information from ConvertKit. They want to help you and they say, remind your subscriber who you are and how they get on this list. Then deliver valuable information. Don't forget to replace this text. That's great. What we can say after someone subscribes to our list, we can say after one day, automatically, this email will be sent. So the email subject after one day can be, how's it going? I could say, hi there, or let me see, I can personalize it. So I can add in a tag, subscriber's name, hi 30, how are you today, yesterday, how to become an online entrepreneur, full video course. Link, insert link, URL, link triggers, open in a new tab, insert, and then go on with typing. Freddy Korpershoek. I will save it, save all. And I want to view it in a browser. Or via email. I send a preview to my email address. And when I take a look, it says how it's going from Freddy Korpershoek. I click on it. And here should be your first name. How are you doing today? Yesterday you signed up for this and that. And this is the information here. You see my address. And here you can unsubscribe. What you can do is the trick. Is that you, after this Freddy Korpershoek, make a few enters. Save it. So that people will not see immediately the unsubscribe button. But they have all the right to unsubscribe if they don't like your email. So you could also leave it as this. So this will be sent after one day. Then you can click over here. And one day after the last email or hours, it can be sent. And you can say, unless it's Tuesday, because every Tuesday I want to send my broadcast email. So I don't want to send them two emails at the same day. So you could put it like that. Or you don't want to send it on Sundays, and then you can uncheck this. And you will see it over here. As long as it is a draft, it will not be sent to someone. But if you publish it and somebody opt in, it will be sent to them. You can also change the order if you want to. And what I like to do, I'm not such an email marketing writer. You can go to freddykorpershoek.com. Go to resources and scroll down and go to Fiverr, click over here, and then you can search for autoresponder emails, enter, and you can take a look over here. I will create an impressive email autoresponder. I will provide 25 day email autoresponders series for just $5. So you can click over here. 25 pre-written email messages for your chosen niche. And then you can see the niches over here. Business online, internet marketing, ebook publishing. And it's only $5. Maybe it's only to help you on the way. And then you can adjust it, of course. So maybe about internet marketing. And it will save you a lot of time. And I don't think it's much money, so why not? Let me try it. And maybe it's only to get an understanding of how you can write your emails. And if you want to take a look over here, it says educational message. Just focus on being incredibly useful. So the second email can be that you give a lot of value. And here you can introduce the product. I already use it in email one. Maybe that's not okay. Then they think, okay, this is a guy who only wants to sell to me. What I could do is in the second email say, you know what? I have a second video for you, where I talk about making a plan. And then this will be a link to that plan. And then I wait for a few days. I say, you know what? 3 days after that email, I almost forgot I was doing something in Fiverr. So I go back to Fiverr. I go for business online and internet marketing. So I select this one. Process to payment. Place your order. Okay, the payment is processed. What industry does this order relate to? Maybe this one. Let me go back to the service. and where those two start order. Okay, I close this and we'll see what will happen. What I like about ConvertKit is when they receive their fourth or fifth email and you say, you know what, buy my course over here, click on this link. And when they buy it, they will automatically be transferred to a different list we assign them to. So if they buy over here, then they don't need all these emails where I'm persuading them to buy my course because they already did. So that's what I like about ConvertKit. For now, I leave it as it is. I save it. And I will think about all these emails I will send to people who subscribe to my list. But what do we need to do now? I saved it. I go to forms. I scroll down. I click over here. And I go to settings. And at the main settings, I scroll down. Sequence settings. Give subscribers an option to opt in to an email sequence. And it's the Freddy Korpershoek ebook. And this will be for all new subscribers. So I could change this also to ebook for myself, that everybody who opts in via the ebook will receive emails from the ebook. And if they opt in through a discount opt-in, then they go to a different list, and that's how you can work. It is a few days later now, and if I go to orders over here, I see that I have my order with autoresponder emails. And order is complete. I can download it over here. And I can download it and I can save it to my Dropbox. I'm here in my Dropbox and this is what I got from her. It is amazing. Business online messages. You can see them. A lot of really nice emails. I go back. And I go for the internet marketing content emails. That's what I asked for. And it says here 7 product creation emails. So that's amazing because that's what my course is all about. So I click on it. And here you can see them. How the heck are you today? It's in great English. You know, that's not my strongest point. So I really like this. This English is okay. It's personal. Of course, I have to change this. But if I want to place this into ConvertKit, I click on it. I copy this text, copy Freddy Korpershoek ebook, and the first email, I replace it with this one, and I start changing the text a little bit. And I say hi, personalize it. My name, I will change it later, but I will just show you how it works now. And the subject, big question, want to be the boss? So now how it's going, and I can publish it one day after they opted in. So I save it, and now I go to my second email. And here you can put your product, freddykorpershoek.com. Copy it, make it a link, open a new tab, insert, and that's how it can work. I don't have to save it. If I go to the third email and to the second one, it's still over here. And that's how I can do this. So I pasted all the emails and they will have all a delay of one day. So each day a person gets this email when they opt in through my ebook that they want to have for free. And the amazing thing is at a certain point, if, for instance, if you read email 3, and you decide to click over here and buy the product I offer, then you can add a rule that when somebody buys the course from this email sequence, they will be transferred to a different sequence and they will no longer receive emails from this sequence. Because if you buy this course over here at IMO 3 and you get IMO 4, then I'm still talking about getting the course. So that will be a little bit weird. And that's amazing about ConvertKit. It will be all automatic and I will show you that in automations. So what I will do, I will go to FerdyKorpershoek one more time. And I want people that exit the website, see my ebook opt-in. So how can I do that? I go back to forms, to the ebook form. I go to settings, style, and I want to change it to a modal. I'll show you how it will look. When people want to leave my website, then it comes up. Exit. The percentage. So if I'm over here, then it should start. It's something like 25%. It's quite a long page. So I can say 20% or after 5 seconds, no matter what. So I choose for 5 seconds. You can also create a link. You copy this text. You paste it here in the button or something. And I leave it as it is. Don't show it after people already have opted in. Save the form. Then I go to the embed code, JavaScript, copy it. I go to my website, edit the front page. I scroll all the way down. And I go to this code block, which already has a JavaScript, and I paste it here below. I save it. Update. I go to Safari. I go to FerdyKorpershoek.com. I wait for a few seconds. And here it is. Download our ebook and learn how to start your online business from scratch. So I will say Ferdy. And I say FerdyKorpershoek@gmail.com. Join now. Your information is 100% saved with us, powered by ConvertKit. I join now. Success. Now check your email to confirm your subscription. I go to my Gmail. I get it as info@FerdyKorpershoek. I can change that. I will go to incentive mail and here I change it to FerdyKorpershoek. Save it. So the next time people will see FerdyKorpershoek, important, confirm your subscription. I click on it. Thanks for signing up. Click the link below to confirm your subscription and you'll be on your way. It's good to have you. I could say, kind regards FerdyKorpershoek. I click over here. Then people go to my welcome page. Here's your ebook. Congratulations, here's your ebook. Good luck reading it and applying it. I downloaded the ebook. And here it is, how to become an online entrepreneur. And people can say, right mouse click, download linked file. And here it is. My ebook, and they can read it and read a lot of valuable stuff. And now they are opted in, so I will receive my first email tomorrow in my email box. I will go to subscribers and I want to import a few subscribers that have purchased my course. I sold my course already 9 times, so I want to add them manually and then give them a tag. How can I do that? I can click on import subscribers and I can import a CSV file. Or I can import them manually by clicking on this plus icon. But before I do that, I need to make a new tag. So I create a tag. It's just for organization. And I have one list with all the subscribers. And I want to give a tag which is called course members. I have one course, so I know which course it is. I save it. And now I start importing them. First name. Plus over here. I paste it and the email, copy it, paste it, the text, course members, save. In subscribers, we work with tags. You see tags over here and segments. I have one tag, it's course members, and it's a list of 11 people. And what tags does is organize people, and what segments does is it organizes tags. So if I would have 3 courses, I would say course 1 members, course 2 members, course 3 members. And I could create a segments with all course members and I would select those 3 tags. We will do that later. For now, I go to automations. So I will create an automatic tag through a link trigger. Maybe it sounds all weird. I will show you step by step what I mean. It works with rules. If this happens, then what action needs to follow? So I click on add rule. And when this happens, this action should take place. So I go for a link trigger. When somebody clicks on this link in an email, what will happen? They can be subscribed to a sequence or unsubscribed from a sequence. They can be subscribed to a form or unsubscribed from a form, add a tag or remove a tag. So I click on the link trigger. This is the name that only I will see. So I'll call this interested in the course. And the direction URL is http://30corpushook.com. When somebody goes to this link, he needs to be added to the tag. And I need to create a new tag. And I call this one the same. Interested in the course. They click on the link to 30corpushook.com, but they did not bought it yet. So I save the rule. And now it's enabled. Now I go to sequences. I've only one. People that are opting in through the email are receiving this sequence in 7 days. And I have a few links, mostly below. I click on it once. And here's the link. I can unlink it. So I unlink it. I can select text. Or, you know what? I can also remove this. And I click here on the link icon, insert link. There's no URL, there's no text. I can select the link triggers over here. I have only one interested in the course. And now you see a lightning bolt over here. I want to open it in a new tab. I click on insert. So now if I click on it, you see this lightning bolt icon. That means it is a link trigger. If this email will be sent to me, for instance, because I just subscribed, and I click on this link, then I will get an automatic tag. I will save it. And then if I go to subscribers and you click on 30, you will see a tag applied. So we will do this. So right now I subscribed again. And as you see, now it is 30corpushook instead of info@30corpushook. And in the settings, I decided that I immediately receive the first email. And the first email has a tag attached to the link trigger. So I open the email. And here is the link with the tag. So I click over here. And now I should be interested in the course. So if I refresh this, and now you see it, I'm interested in the course. So that's how it works. What is next? If I go to automations, I go to my rule, I scroll down. You see that there are two people already that are interested in the course. So if I go to subscribers, I see that two subscribers are interested in the course. If somebody buys the course, I want to remove them from the stack. How can we do that? I go to forms. Create a new form. It has to be a really simple form with the first name and the email address. I go to the settings. People who purchase the course. No sequence yet. I can make that later. And I leave this as it is for now. I save the form. Now I need to go to my website to optimize press. I go to the backend. I need to go to optimize press dashboard. And I need to go to email marketing services. I scroll down and I click on ConvertKit and I need to fill in an API key. I go to ConvertKit to account. And here it is. I copy this. I paste it over here and I save the settings. So right now, OptimizePress has a connection with my ConvertKit account. Then I need to go to Optimize Member, General Options, and I go to Define Mailing List Autoresponder Configurations. If we take a look at the membership levels, you see level 1 is the Entrepreneur member. So I need to select level 1 members, ConvertKit, people who purchase the course. So when somebody buys the course, they will be added through this form into this list. That's great. I save all the changes. And now I want to automate a few other things. I go to automations and I want to add a new rule. Add rule. When somebody subscribes to a form, which is people who purchase the course, I want to remove the tag interested in the course. I can add more options. So what else? I could subscribe to a sequence. I don't have a sequence yet for people, but I want to remove the tag and I want to add a tag, course members. Save the rule. You can also have more triggers and one action, or one trigger and a couple of actions. So if I go to subscribers, I have Ferdinand at my test server and he's interested in the course because I clicked over here on the link to FerdiKorpshoek. So if I go to FerdiKorpshoek.com and I buy the course, I go to my email and what do I see here? My username and password info, and here it says confirm your subscription. I confirm my subscription. Thanks, your subscription is confirmed. And now if I go to ConvertKit, I have a new subscriber, so I go to subscribers, Ferdinand, and I'm not anymore interested in the course. For now, I am a course member. So if I go to automations and I click over here, I see that this happens. Ferdinand was tagged course member after subscribing to people who purchased the course. Ferdinand was removed and this tag was removed. So that is amazing about ConvertKit. Everything is automated. I don't have to take a look. Everything will be on automatic pilot. What I have to do, I go to forms and I need to change this, of course, settings. And I go to this email. Thanks for purchasing the course. Talk to you later. So that's how it works. Save. So one more thing, if I go to automations, when somebody buys the course, I want to remove them from the sequence that tries to sell them the course. So if you click here, people who purchase the course, what needs to be done more? Click on the plus over here. And I want to unsubscribe them from the sequence, which is FerdiKorpshoek ebook. Save the rule. So I go to the homepage. What will happen if I go to FerdiKorpshoek.com? They will get an opt-in. They leave their name and their email address. Then they will receive this sequence after 1 day, 2 day, 3 days. And over here, I'm giving them valuable information. And at the end, I say, hey, go to this course. If they click over here, they will get a tag interested in the course, so I can send all the interested people another email with a special bonus to buy the course. So they are interested but have not bought yet. If they buy the course, then they will be removed from this sequence, because if they buy over here and after a day I say again, here you can buy the course, that does not make any sense. So they will be removed from this list. You can even add them to a different list. And what will happen when they buy the course? They will get a new tag, which is course members. And if I want to send them an email after that, a broadcast, I can make a new broadcast. I can send it to all subscribers and I can add a filter. And I only want to send them to people with certain tags, which are course members or interested in the course. And in that way, I only have 14 subscribers right now, but if you have a very big list, then it's a really nice way to narrow down the people you want to find And so you'll keep an overview in your ConvertKit mailing list, and you can reach all kinds of people using the segments and the tags. And what I like about ConvertKit, I said it before, you have only one list with subscribers. So if a subscriber is in five lists, you don't pay for five subscribers, you still pay only for one subscriber. That's how it works. I'm uploading a new video into my course, so I could say all subscribers with the tag course members, add a filter, and then it's okay. There are 12 recipients. Next step, and I can say new course chapter online. Hi guys, or hi subscriber's name. I have some great news. 30. Broadcast is currently a draft. I can preview it in the browser. Hi there. Really simple. You can change the template to classic. So there's some more styling. Or the modern. This one. I leave it as text only. I can even send it as an email to myself. Send preview. And I can go to the next step. It goes to 12 recipients. It will be sent immediately. I can schedule it. I say I want to send it tomorrow. And I can save it as a draft, or I can send the broadcast. I don't do this because this is another real message. But if you click here, then it will send it to 12 recipients. And that's how it works. In the next chapter, we will take a look at more ways to get more opt-ins into your website. So this automatic funnel will start working and you will get sales from people that opt in into your mailing list. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it. Please feel free to like this video, to subscribe, or to leave a comment, and I'll see you next time.